someone said that this was an extension of Satan and
we heard that.
The pagan, right? And you know, and it was drawing a parallel of this and Burning Man, you know, which has got a reputation for nudity and stuff, right? And you know, I said, well, on the radio, I said, well, you know, there's a lot of things I've done that I'm not real proud of.
I did hear that.
That I've done things that have been stupid or wrong, you know, and I've gotten over a lot of things. And I said, you know, I don't drink or take drugs, and I don't advocate doing that, you know. And I said, no, if that's pagan, I'm Donald Duck.
Okay,
so that's the
You're
line.
Right. Yeah.
If that's pagan, then I'm Donald Duck. Yeah. So, you know, I'd love to meet that man.
Absolutely.
In February 2015, a crew of highly skilled volunteers began to arrive in Derry, Londonderry, in Northern Ireland. Many of them were from California and had worked in the Nevada desert alongside artist David Best to create his legendary temples for the Burning Man Festival. In Derry, the goal was to build a new temple, with David and event producers Artichoke, on one of the hills overlooking the city. It would be burned to the ground on the 21st of March in a spectacle that would hopefully attract people from far and wide. Bonfires to commemorate historical events are a tradition in Northern Ireland, but this one would be different. Collaboration between the international crew and local people was crucial to the success of the project.
Okay, everybody shut up. Okay.
Artichoke gave cameras to some of the participants and invited them to record what happened. This is their story of how the temple was built.
Many, many years ago, I was involved in an accident. It was I was a bystander in a gang shooting, and got shot through the chest with a pretty big gun, and it basically, basically broke my back. It was like a 44 Magnum that I got shot in my chest, and in effect, basically paralyzed me, kind of from the chest down. So I'm in a wheelchair. That was 23 years ago. Pretty much after that period, I actually went traveling for about 10 years. I was actually just looking for where I wanted to be and got involved with Burning Man. 2004, I went out to the desert for the first time, and David Best had a temple called the Temple of Stars, which was just this absolutely beautiful, beautiful structure. I think I could say I probably had my first spiritual encounter. It sounds kind of hokey, but I was kind of sold hook, line, and sinker at that point. It's such an honor and a privilege to be able to do this. I know how it affects my community, and being able to bring this out of my community and sort of like share this with other people is just huge.
So the story about the temple would all started off in March for myself. I thought it would be important to bring you here. This is one of the three interfaith fences here in Londonderry that divide communities. This would be the Fountain interfaith and Bishop Street interfaith. And basically what it does is help protect communities from attack and divide them. As my life as being a youth and community worker, this played a big part of it. Basically stopping young people getting caught up in interfaith baller in trouble. And thank goodness at the minute for the last couple of years it's been very, very quiet, so it has.
Hello. My name is Martin Mulroe. And I work as an artist, sort of, sometimes. And I've been involved with David Best's temple project at the top of the hill here in Derry. And I'm gonna cut that there.
My name's Caroline, and I will be 52 very shortly. I myself am no different to anybody else. We all have losses in our lives. I've had no more, no less than other people. I had cancer myself 10 years ago now, and the treatment left me quite fatigued, and unfortunately I had to leave my job. So that was a loss in the future, a loss in my health, I lost my profession. But other things have dropped into place, and that is really why I'm linking in with the temple. The temple is about dealing with your losses, things that you've been carrying, baggage that's been holding you back. The temple is very much a place where, if you're ready and if you want to, you can take representations of those things to the temple. It is a beautiful, safe place where hopefully people from Derry and the wider environs can leave things that have been holding them back.
My name is John. My name is John Butler. This is J9. So it is. J9 has just woken me up. She's taken me for breakfast. So she has.
It's a great you know, privilege for me to work on this. I've been aware of David's work for about 10, 12 years now. I've seen some of his temples in the desert, and to have one come here to our community is remarkable, you know. And it's going to be interesting. It's going to be good. It's going to be an intense build, but I know we're more than up to it, and I look forward to see it unfold.
What do you do?
It's recording. Well, here it is, day one, out in the site. The road in's been built, and look at the view over Derry. Hopefully when the temple's up, the whole of Derry will be able to see it. Here I am, middle of the temple. Namaste. Get out! Help! Help! I can't get out!
I just came back up to basically show you something that I've learned for the past while. For myself, as I said before, I haven't never been this area until this week. And here, this is where my grandmother would have been reared. So it was, and that's all it is now. It's a load of rubble and stones. And this is actually at the site. So it is. So they learn that there. It's a surprise for me, and it's such a beautiful place where they were brought up, so it was.
By late February, the construction of the temple was well underway in a giant warehouse on the outskirts of the city.
See my breath. This house is so cold. Thank you.
was a very, very, very snowy day, very cold. You notice my raspy, manly voice. Most of the staff got moved up to the site today, so although they couldn't actually do much work at the site because there's a ton of snow. What else can I tell you? Everybody's got kind of a lot of aches and pains and colds and sniffles, myself included. I'm kind of sore. But we got a lot done down here, did a lot of mosaicing. I think we've actually got some people coming in tomorrow, and actually we had some other people mosaicing today, which was nice as well. It's pretty nasty, isn't it?
It just
keeps on going round and round. So this is the hospital infirmary. Here's patient zero. Patient Zero is doing really good this morning.
Oh yeah. What was in that green and orange pill?
I'm in my bed. I ended up getting really sick today. I got sick this morning when I got up, like throwing up, and I got sick on site. Fortunately, today was a shorter day, so we only worked till 1. And I've been in bed all day, or all afternoon. I have my trusty bucket. A hot water bottle. And some ginger tea. And, I'm going to crash out.
Well, hi there. It's morning of the 4th, Wednesday. As you can see, the sun at last is out. Snow's on the melt. Hopefully this is going to be it now. We're going to have no hindrance from the weather to complete this build. It's looking good. Phase one of the temple. A whole lot more to do. But you can see it's going to be pretty impressive, you know. And we're excited to get going on it and get these lifts up, get a crane in. You know, hopefully that's going to, you know, help logistically in getting this stuff done, you know. I'm sure I'll become more eloquent as this goes on.
Project itself, the intention of it, I find that it really has helped me personally, maybe altered my perspective about just a difficult time. The idea of putting things that are on top of you into something and purging it, sort of as a burn, is an idea that's appealing, I would think, to most people. In a way, you know, the idea of being able to get rid of what your biggest worries are, that has to appeal to people. But I don't think the temple really works like that, the project. It isn't a magical thing in a wizardy sense. It doesn't make stuff just go away, but it does, I think, help you accept and move on. You don't have to carry stuff if you want to. If you want to carry stuff, carry stuff.
Thank you.
fashion instrument. It would be hot dogs.
They come over here, they build temples, they take our jobs and our women. Temples.
So it is now Sunday morning. I am out with Jack, who's just recovered. That's a recovered Jack, or recovering. I've recovered, or recovering.
From the sickness.
From the sickness. Yes, it wasn't a drunken sickness. It was a sickness.
Today we've pretty much been rained off. Really high winds up on top of the hill that are preventing us from completing the lift of the top sections. We had a really good day on Thursday. Less so on Friday. I feel bad for the crew because everybody is really keen to get this thing together, and we're being really knocked around hard by the weather and the right conditions to use the crane safely. The DBS has all now been moved up from Campsie, and it's ongoing in the marquees on site, and it's come together very nicely.
What you're seeing is kind of the centre where all the decorative work for the temple has been assembled before it is fitted. We have here is some crew members and volunteers. So here you see all the different, how intricate the temple looks, and these are all the different sections that are used in decorating the body of the temple. Incredible amount of work in organizing all of this and you know, it's kind of systemizing all the different sections. This is a table with more sections. As you can see, it's incredibly intricate stuff. Here we've got patterns being arranged. There's no real decision as to where these will go yet. Basically, wherever they fit, they will be assembled and then decided where they will go. But what you see is all the different shapes that are used to make the temple look the way it does. It's an incredible amount of work involved in this, you know. So what we're doing here, we're dropping on the third level. Well, actually, per the drawing, the second level, third including the ground base. It's a nice day. We've got a little bit of wind action up here. We're about 50 feet off the ground.
It's better not go on Facebook, John.
For a lot of us, we had a very difficult day when the spire went on. It is a solid spire at the very top. And we were all in the middle of working, and David just said, right, everybody stop, this spire is for you. And he asked us just to come up and write whoever we wanted to dedicate the temple, our work, our wishes to. We all came up and just wrote on it what we wanted, what our intentions were for the temple. Sorry. And despite looking at me, it wasn't sad. It was just, it was calm. It was lovely. So we all wrote who and what we wanted to dedicate the temple to. And then we all just stood back and the crane came along and it was attached, and again we just all watched in peaceful contemplation as the spire was put up at the top of the temple. And it was a lovely act for us who had put the effort in, some a lot more than me, that we knew that what we had written was up at the top of the temple. It was just amongst us, it was there, but it was private.
All of a sudden, dozens and dozens of people seem to be coming from everywhere. They've obviously heard about the temple. They're all coming to help build it. And whilst we've got bad weather, it's going up.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, it's just another day at the office. I don't know what these people have been going on about, this bad weather. It's been gorgeous. It's been like this every day. I don't have a cold anymore. Oh, actually, I guess I should tell you when it is. We're Friday before opening. And I would imagine, well, actually, knowing David, we'll probably be going until sort of early tomorrow morning, or late tomorrow morning. Stuff's endless. It's sort of like you could spend eons and eons and eons and eons, and it can still be sort of like, there could always still be something else and something better.
Hey, Kev!
Hey, Mom!
Maybe this is a good time.
Okay, whatever you think. That's the DBS area. See all the different aspects of DBS we've got stored down there. Basically, David goes through that and selects everything and decides where it goes. And sometimes he has an idea what he wants. Sometimes it's spontaneous. He just makes it up as he goes. He looks at looks where a need is and comes up with something on the spot. It's a nice mixture, you know. It's an absolutely gorgeous object. There's nothing like it. He's invented a whole new language in monumental sculpture.
What's going on over here?
We're just asking each other how tired we are and who's the tiredest, and probably you.
I don't think so.
Oh, I'm just pooped. I just wish it all to be over and wish it all to be open.
You want it to be all over?
No, the building. And I want it to be open. Mm. I want all the hard work to stop.
Come tomorrow. Anything worth having, Caroline? It's not easy. Come on.
As an overweight 50-year-old, I have put more than enough effort into this. I have put out more effort the last month than I think I have in the last year, so I have done me dues. So I just wanted to open and enjoy.
Here I am, and this is Ireland, as usual. My mom is doing this video for me and the temple, and you can see around me, I think. Where everything is. My mom's gonna show you all around Ireland. Well, not all around Ireland, just like...
What city are we in?
Turn the camera around. No, around. The other way. Yeah, okay, now turn it around.
Right.
There's Marty that's letting us use his camera. Hello.
Okay. Hello.
And also,
look, you can see the temple up there.
Up there's the temple. The sun might hurt you, your eyes, so be warned. Wear sunglasses. Warning. Please, someone leave at the comment down below saying that warning. Don't let the sun hurt your eyes, okay?
I am going to pick up my girlfriend, so I'm kind of happy. And I get to stay in a hotel, and there's the potential of a bath tonight, so things are kind of good. There you go. So, I'm at the airport. After a crazy day yesterday. Just meeting my lovely, lovely, lovely woman. And actually, I'm hiding around the corner because she doesn't actually know I'm here. So, I'm tired and everything else. So, here goes. Any moment now. Here's my hot mama. So we're in Belfast Airport, and we're swerving down. I'm gonna follow the bottom. Ooh, nice bum.
That's what my mommy made, and other people. Here are tons of people that made this. the people that made this.
Yep, this is the crew.
Oh, that's a big crew.
Come on, this is...
Oh, all the scones are getting a little hasty. There he goes.
I got a million things to
say. Hi. Hello.
No. So that's how you, that's, ladies and gentlemen, is how you build a temple.
Bravo.
That's how you build it. Sobriety, you know, and suicide, you know, those things are all. Do that for a lot of different people, okay? People that work on this, who've been in recovery, there's people that have come here and have stayed clean. It's really the soul of the project, okay?
Good job, man. Thank you.
Today is the day that the temple opens. The amount of effort that went in yesterday is unbelievable. The temple is finished. It'll be open to the public. And yesterday a lot of us were just saying it's strange the feelings we're having. It's almost like your child's going to school for the first day. Or it's like the temple was ours. We were the only people there. You know, the odd media person came, but it was sort of our temple. And now it's going to be open to the public. And there's just like butterflies in our stomach. It's, oh, will they like it? Will they love it?
This is for the
might be a bit naughty.
I don't think you're one, but somebody. Speaking here to a local artist.
Mr. Webster, how do you feel about this project?
I just think it's wonderful. I like the whole idea that of untrammeled imagination in creating it, and then providing a space where people can put their distress, their anxiety, their hopes, their wishes, their dreams, and they're completely free to do it in whatever way they like. And they're all encapsulated in there. And then on Sunday we recognize that it has a limited life and it goes up in smoke and it takes all our hopes and dreams with them. And I just think it's a wonderful idea. And
aside from that, what do you think about the structure? I'm sure you have an interest in the art and the structure.
I'm fascinated because there's...
The intricacy of it, you know.
Yeah, there's a very simple... basic design,
yeah,
but it's clearly allowed an awful lot of people mm-hmm. to contribute their mm-hmm. own thoughts in these panels around the side. It's almost like classic Islamic architecture mm-hmm. in its use of sort of abstract patterns mm-hmm. rather than naturalistic patterns.
Mm.
I just think it's absolutely gorgeous. I think it's a thing of real beauty, and we're very lucky to have it in this town.
There is no religious affiliation. Belongs to everybody, belongs to no one. How do we get that message out? Let's hope this is a unifying thing.
It took me a couple of days before I decided there was something that I wanted to put in there. I was brought up in a boys' home just on the other side of the river, and I was in a group of 38 boys, and we're involved in an inquiry into historical institutional abuse. And as part of that inquiry, I came across some photographs that were taken back in the 50s and the 60s, and one of the photographs was taken outside the Guildhall in the city on the steps, and in that photograph were my two brothers. And it was only when I saw the photograph a couple of years back that I realized my two brothers were in a photograph that I was in, and I didn't know who they were. We'd gone into Termin Baca in 1956. The three of us were separated, taken to separate parts of the home. And it was 8 years before I actually got to meet my two brothers again. By that time, this photograph had already been taken. Most of the memories from Termin Baca were gone now. I wanted to be rid of anything that had to do with Tiernan Macha. I know of that group of people in that photograph, at least 9 of them have committed suicide. Now that was something worth bringing to the temple. And I brought that photograph with me and I put it up in memory of those people who aren't here anymore, who were gone, you know. Some of them died brutal deaths. They're just lost. Their memories are gone, and we're the only people that remember them, because a lot of them haven't got families. Most of them haven't even got gravestones. I think this was a fitting place to put that up there. A memory to them, maybe in some way through the burning and the fire, a blessing to them as well. And on the other side of it, maybe a way of saying, that's it, done.
Here in my communities, there'll be 2 bonfires a year, the 11th of July and the 11th of August. And since I've been young, it's been part of your culture, your heritage. And you're 2 generations, 3 generations front of you would have done that in the summer. And for even the young people that got there, it gives them a sense of pride in their community. And it's like David Best and his team built that temple, and the pride they must be looking at it. The same pride they feel is how a young person would feel building a bonfire in their own community. So it's going to be very difficult if it's trying to look at an alternative for bonfires.
Personally, like, my vision for the future as a shared city, I don't think we've achieved that yet. So we haven't. We have quite a bit of work to do. And even with the temple bringing people together, I don't think it's going to achieve it.
Having the chance to even go and visit the temple this week, it sort of helped me relieve a lot and write a wee message there. So I know what it's doing to the rest of the community here in Londonderry. And it's like, it is bringing people together, bringing an area where lots and lots of people haven't been. Like, I'm looking at my Facebook and the majority of my friends, all I see is the David Best Temple. So in my eyes, it's a great thing, and it's a chat in the media and Twitter and stuff like that there. Everybody's talking about it.
Does it make sense to build something so beautiful and destroy it? Is it supposed to make sense? Thinking back on the original meaning of the word Holocaust and the burnt offering, and that's what people are doing. They're offering up their troubles, their burdens. And I put them in here in notes on pieces of wood and bits of paper and photographs. And I'm just going to set fire to them. And maybe there is healing in it. I hope for some people there is.
Oh, I should be vlogging this.
Hey guys, try and walk on the... in case you fall.
Alright.
Guys, down from there, please.
What?
Just walk on the footpath. Adam, temple in one word.
What?
A temple in one word, can you describe it? This is your first experience of seeing it, what do you think?
Amazing.
Amazing. Damien?
Beautiful.
Charlie? Oh. Dean?
Effortful.
What word?
What could effortful be in one word?
Yeah?
Hey Gabe, how are you doing?
Hey.
It's so beautiful.
Oh.
Can we sit somewhere down there?
You can do whatever you like. You can write messages.
And then they're all going to get burnt down.
So yeah, they're going to get burnt down, isn't it? What?
Well, there's no point in writing messages. They're just going to get burnt.
It's just a personal message for you to let go of. That's the whole point of it.
Oh.
Yeah.
You didn't tell me that.
I haven't been finished explaining it to you. You gotta listen, man. Right, what you do is you go in there and see what other people have written and see what you think. Then make your own mind up. We're in no rush. We can stay as long as we like, okay?
Yeah, okay.
Okay.
Well, the girls have finally made it.
And we're very pleased to be here, Caroline.
And what do you think of it with the lights on?
Well, I just saw the light on. I said, thank God somebody's at home. Have you the kettle on? Maybe the wine breathing.
No, what do you think of this place, Cara?
Well, I love reading all the messages that people have put on here, because I think that's what it's about. It's about letting go of stuff. And do you feel like you would want to write something yourself?
Yeah. There's no pens, though.
There is pens. See the people in yellow hats, darling?
Yeah.
They have pens.
My father, who now has passed away, and on the 21st of March, it's going to be his birthday as well. So it's sort of giving the opportunity of lighting the temple. I'll be actually thanking my father that day. 3 years ago, I lost my best friend to suicide. So it's a very emotional weekend for myself now, and a lot of thinking about the past. But my wife now is due a baby on the end of June, so it's also looking towards the future.
So, Saturday morning, and the loadout has begun. Tree, you ready to let this go?
Oh yeah.
Yeah, I'm ready to let it go.
Lovely.
Everything is impermanent. We yes. Have to let it go.
Yeah.
We're gonna set it to the wind.
Absolutely, I like that. Yeah.
What's happening today?
There's a little burn happening.
Okay. And can you tell me about yourself and your experience? I actually thought of cold at the moment. You sound pretty good at the moment.
Yeah.
You're drugged up to the eyeballs.
Thank you.
So tell me about you and what you're about and all that stuff.
Do I have to really do this?
Yeah.
I have to really do this. Yeah. So my name's Kahai.
Mm-hmm.
Got brought out here by you.
Yeah.
From California.
Uh-huh.
And came out here to help with the temple.
Okay, and so you're a temple guardian, aren't you?
I'm a temple guardian.
And actually you're on the temple guardian council, I think somebody said.
Yes.
So you know quite a bit about temple guardians.
And keeping the space, yes.
Mm-hmm.
Presbyterian minister condemned us as satanic through the week. I think the people I saw come here over the last week had many, many things on their mind, but very, very few of them had to do with Satan. There were people who came down here in wheelchairs, people who came down pushing their parents, their grandparents, their children, and all of them with a different state of mind when they left than when they'd come in.
The Presbyterian minister, if he actually went and visited the site and met David Best, I think he would understand it a lot more. The buzz around it and just the calm around the temple. It seems to me as people basically moving, looking towards the future and leaving the past behind, and it's a good way of doing it and using that kind of artwork.
I've met some amazing people over the weekend, so I have, and looking back now and being asked to burn the temple, there's 100,000 other people could have been burning it instead of me, so there was. So, you all ready for tonight?
I'm ready, I'm getting ready.
Good?
Yep.
The weather's good?
It looks like it might not snow.
No, it's probably California.
Don't say it. If it doesn't snow, it's going to be a good night. Is it a big crowd?
Yeah, they're starting to come up the hill now.
Goodness. It's been a real experience, hasn't it?
Yeah, it's really good. So yeah.
Thank you for working with me.
You're welcome.
Yeah.
There seems to be a nice, gentle atmosphere. And a heightened and sense of anticipation.
The thing that's in most people's lips is it looks too good to burn. And it is. But on the 12th of July and the 12th of August every year we do it. And don't give it a second thought, because then there's a cause, and the cause makes it worthwhile, and the cause makes the effort worthwhile.
I
lost my child in 2001, and I was very, very ill during the funeral time of it, and I never had the type of ceremony that you'd wanted. So I put the name and everything, and it's in there, and this is for Axel, so as much as anything else. And discovered whenever I walked around, there were lots of other wee names of wee babies and lost children and families and people that had... And there's something so profound about it. And we need this. It's nothing to do with religion. It's got to do with spirit. I just love the idea of it. I think of it like a beautiful dawn or a fabulous sunset. I think of it like a moment when you're looking out at the sea, or whenever you just capture something beautiful in nature. That's what it's all about. It's those tiny moments that actually resonate inside of you. And so... it'll be there. It'll be gone. It'll never age. It'll never grow. It's like my baby. It'll never know decay. It'll never know anything. When you're near it, you can smell the new wood. You can smell it. It's like something fresh and something pure. And then it'll be gone.
We're part of the guardians. They're a gaggle of guardians. We basically just have to stand here. I think certain people from the crew are going to be going in and setting light to it. So we've kind of been armed with tissues and water, and because so many people have invested in this emotionally, and me myself as well, I kind of put in a memorial to my friend. It's a friend of mine, Louise. She died 3 years ago. 4 years ago now. And it was like from her funeral, and I was holding on to it for so long, and I think I kind of want to forget about her being dead and just remember her as a person. And I think a lot of people have been doing that too. I also rolled up wee personal messages and kind of rolled them on a piece of paper and put them in there too, just kind of personal things that, you know, it's not for anybody else to read. It's just wee things that I want to put to bed.
People themselves are going to decide what they've got from it. But I don't think it's something we can measure it. I mean, I came around skeptical at the start, thinking of what benefit it actually brought to us and to the thousands of other people. I know personally for me, it was an experience worth being a part of. And I think for a lot of people, the pain and the memories that they've left behind here hopefully are, if not gone, at least softened by the fact that there was a lot of shared pain here. I think we all got something from it, and maybe right now not everybody realizes that, but it certainly was something worth doing. And I'm glad we had somebody like David Best. I'm glad we had the people that had the foresight to actually say, look, let's do this. Let's just build it. Let's burn it. Let's see what happens. Let's give it back to the people. Let them take what they wanted from it, because nobody was forced to come here. Nobody was forced to put a thought in there. Nobody was forced to put a memory in there. It was our choice. And if it was our choice to put it there, it's our choice to let it go. And maybe now the opportunity of letting some of that go. Letting the memory of a destroyed childhood or a lost father or a daughter or people who died in horrible circumstances, you know, the opportunity of putting that down and saying, it's happened. Can we learn from it? Can we move forward from it?
Yeah.
I'm going to go to the hospital.